Hey guys, it's me Matteo here and welcome back to another Redstone tutorial. Today we are going to be taking a look at bamboo farms, ranging from super easy to build and really small to ridiculously fast and not hard to build but also not really easy. So yeah, let's begin. This first design is a really simple one that doesn't do anything to speed up the growth. So as you can see, it's just a bamboo plant, an observer, redstone, and piston. So every time that the bamboo grows, the observer will detect that and piston will push the bamboo into the hopper and into the chest. And this piston, by the way, doesn't have to be a sticky piston, it can also be a normal piston. This next farm uses bone meal to make the bamboo grow super fast. So of course this is really fast, but it also uses bone meal, which is quite expensive. And I know that this looks very complicated, but I just overcomplicated it. You can probably make a smaller design, but as you can see, it's faster than the hopper is. The hopper can't keep up. But of course, it does use a lot of bone meal, and bone meal is expensive, so I would not recommend building it. This next farm is not designed by me. This was actually designed by Il Mango, and it uses theoretic pulses to force the bamboo plant to grow faster. So when we flick this lever, you can see the bamboo will start growing, and yeah, it's really fast. Okay, the next design is this one. This one uses quantum ticks to force the bamboo to grow really fast. And the redstone is very simple, but this doesn't work in 1.15 anymore. Only in version 1.14. So, as you can see, it's very fast. The hoppers can't keep up with this one. It does make a lot of noise, and it doesn't work anymore in 1.15. Let's start with the tutorial for the Xerotic farm. Place a building block with redstone torches on either side, like this. And place a sand block on top of the block, and one block sand block on top of the torch. Then place sticky pistons. Like this, and place blocks behind the torches with redstone on top, and then a block on either side, and place normal pistons on top and under that building block, and then the same on the other side. So you should now have something that looks like this. The middle block, should not be moving. At least it does move, but it shouldn't be looking like it's moving. And place a sticky piston right here with a block with a lever on top. This is going to be your on-off switch. Now you can just plant your bamboo like this. And it should be, yes, it works. Now we are going to make the harvesting system. So place an observer facing upwards on top of one of the redstone redstone dusts. And place building block on top, the piston on the side. And now all you have to do is place a chest and a hopper above. Of course, the piston is going to throw the bamboo away, so put some glass around it to make sure it doesn't fly everywhere. And yeah, this should be it. you can see the bamboo is flowing. So that's the tutorial for the Geratic farm. Okay, so now we are going to build the Quantum Tick farm. So the first thing that you need to do is get that sand to shake. The way you do that is you place a chest with two boats on top. Like this. And then you just place your sand. As you can see, the sand is shaking. So that's exactly what we are going to do. So place the chest with the boat on top. And then another boat on top. Like this. Now we need to push it a little bit that way. But not too much. Okay, let's see if it worked. It did. So now we have our sand shaking. Next thing we are going to do is place our bamboo on top. This is another thing that's a little bit hard. So get yourself some bamboo. And plant it. Now, when you right click, it will immediately get destroyed. So we'll go to those, go to options, controls, and map, and the use item place block key to enter, or any other key on your keyboard. And then just hold down enter, and there you go. Just keep doing that until you have enough bamboo. Like this. Next thing we are going to do is do a little bit of work on the water streams that are going to be collecting your bamboo. Wait, let's. So, place your blocks like this. Next thing we are going to do is place a chest like this and then get our hoppers. You will need a lot of hoppers because otherwise this thing is going to overflow in a couple of minutes. Place the chest, place hoppers like this and then some more. Now we're going to make a wall. Like this, just around the whole farm. To prevent the water from spilling out. Then place waters in the water source blocks in the outer corners. So that looks like this. Now when we throw an item, it will always end up inside of one of those chests. Next thing we are going to do is make the slime box sweeper that's going to be shooting all of those, that's going to be harvesting all of the bamboo. So place slime box like this. It's one extra one. Now we're going to make the pistons that are going to be pushing this thing. Like that, and pistons on top, and some immovable objects, right here. Then some blocks with Then some blocks with redstone on top. Let's get rid of that bucket. And now we're gonna make the redstone clock. So laser repeaters like this, and then some redstone dust. Then place a block here and stick piston here, a block here, observer facing downwards right here. Oh, and it already started the farm by accident. Then place redstone on top, get yourself leather, and there we go. You can now turn it off and turn it back on. So as you can see, bamboo is absolutely being fired out of this. So let's get rid of that. We obviously do need a wall here. That's a little bit higher, but this should be enough. So I'm making this out of glass because I think it's cool to see all the bamboo. But if you don't like it, you can also make it out of normal solid blocks like concrete or cobblestone or anything you would like. And as you can see now, when we flick the lever, the farm is going to kick into action and bamboo is slowly flowing in. So let's turn this machine off. So yeah, this is the Quantum Tick bamboo farm. Really simple to build and really fast, but it sadly does not work in Minecraft version 1.15 anymore. So please let me know if you also want the 1.15 version of this farm. If you do want that, I'll make a tutorial on that. So I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, like, subscribe and hit the bell, and I'll see you guys in the next video. When I was editing this video, I discovered that there were some strange flickering things going on this screen. I have no idea what it is, but I'll try my best to make sure that in the next video they won't be there. So yeah, I do apologize for that.